Major Ken, how's it going?
Very good.
Yeah? Let's try one more time. When I say how's it going, you say anything you want. Good morning. Good morning, Major Ken.
Good morning.
Perfect. Much better. Thank you so much. Come in. Thank you. I'm Soren Anzu. This is my colleague Alexandra. We're both from the company Economics. We're a digital agency in Constanza. Who here has come for the Google Data Studio site? Perfect. Who here has come for like kind of general automation and analytics stuff? Who here has come for the aforementioned cats? There will be cats. Hopefully you will enjoy them. Come in. Thank you. Before we begin, I know it's not warranted since we haven't really provided any value for you as of now. My colleague is really excited about the presentation. It's basically 99% her work. Could we give her an unnecessarily large amount of applause at the beginning? Thank you so much. Next slide, please. Perfect. So we're a digital agency in Constanza. We have national and international clients. We've been on the market for roughly 11 years now. So in terms of kind of reporting and analytics, you might be thinking we were doing something like this. This is kind of similar to what was the movie with Tom Cruise with the Minority Report and was doing virtual reality reports. The truth was much sadder than that because we were mostly doing, not necessarily by hand, we weren't that outdated, but we were just using kind of getting data from a lot of systems and kind of patching it together, and we didn't have a system that would allow us to do the right things at the right time and also automate it in a way so that we wouldn't spend time doing all of these things and we would use our brains and create awesome things, not create reports for our clients. Next slide, please. You must admit, we were guilty of kind of using outdated tools for a long time. But hopefully during this presentation and if you get to discuss it with you further, we can solve our mistakes and you can forgive our sins so far. Next slide, please. So I don't know if you're familiar with this gentleman, Kanye West. He's a recently reborn Christian Jesus follower, and this is one of his quotes, "I'm complete service of God." For us as an agency of Economics, we believe in data a lot, even if it's kind of at the beginning maybe we weren't really knowing how to use it properly. We hope to solve our sins, and hopefully we will solve this issue. So we have seen the light, just as Kanye West did. We have seen the newborn son of Google, that's the old Google Data Studio logo. For those of you who are nitpicking, yes, there's a new one now. Next slide, please. How many of you are familiar with Google Data Studio? Yeah, good. Do you like it? It's cool. Yeah, we think it's cool as well. It could be improved. So some of the things that we like is that we can basically automate almost anything. We can push data, we can export data, we can schedule data, we can automate data. It's amazing. There are multiple resources and integrations. Most of them are free, which is again awesome. Please come in. There's a high level of customer visibility. It's also very easy to use. It's one of the basic tools that we get started when we talk about like the performance department or analytics or data. There's people using it in kind of the first week that they're with the agency, the company. And obviously a big plus for us is that it's free, so we don't have to spend money on something that would kind of make sense for clients, but not necessarily for us. In terms of cons, not all of the integrations are free. Sometimes it can be a bit slow, and it does tend to get a bit buggy. If you've been with the tool from the beginning, you will notice like kind of with all Google tools, it starts in beta, and then it kind of hopefully improves over time. They kind of remove the label. We think it's still kind of in beta right now, but we kind of work with what we have. Next slide. Perfect. So the thing we want to talk about is kind of twofold. Number one is what are we using Google Data Studio for? How are we aggregating data? What are we doing with that data? And then the second part is how are we actually automating this so we shouldn't have to spend time sending reports or scheduling reports. So there are five main things, five kind of use cases that we have generated within the agency. Number one is KPI comparisons, either year over year, month over month, or week over week. Then there's the integration with Search Console and Google Analytics. There's a Google Sheets integration where we're getting data from other places, pushing it to Google Sheets, and then getting it into Google Data Studio. And we also have this monthly report delivery automation, which will be kind of a little bit about that in the end. I'm really excited about it because we've kind of researched and created something specifically for you guys. I hope you're excited as I am when we were creating it. And finally, the last thing is how can we get up some of key results highlighted through this kind of new feature called conditional formatting. I think I'll pass it on to my colleague to talk about kind of each specific case study.
Alright, so that's a tough act to follow. So as you can see, every scorecard, chart, or any type of way that you want to showcase information in Data Studio supports comparisons as regarding to date range. As of lately, Google has added more date ranges to its drop-down list, its date range filters. So, there are new general expressions. There are new general expressions such as last month, this month, last week, this year to date that can help us set a date and automate the reporting process, because whenever we hit the comparison button, be it previous period or previous year, Google automatically knows how to analyze that data, and it shows interactively how it has evolved during the time set of the report. As you can see, this is one way that we have chosen to show you some yearly comparison. One of the new features, relatively new, is the expand collapse option. So, if you organize your dimensions in a hierarchy, let's say from year to month to week to day, you can click the expand collapse and you will see a preview of the principal dimension, and then you can collapse with all of the other steps in the hierarchy. This is a cool new feature that wasn't available since the beginning of Google Data Studio.
Excuse me for interrupting. Is it possible to get a link from this table? I guess this is a dummy data, it's not a real data from
No, it's real, but yes, we can.
We're raw like that. No, this is kind of all real data.
Yes. Is it possible maybe to share the template of Google Data Studio so I don't
have to take a picture
every single time because there are good ideas?
So we will be sharing like all of the presentations, we'll be sending to everyone here. And also, we wanted to mention it at the end, but thanks for mentioning it. We're also really excited about kind of, even at this, we think we're at the basic level, but we're excited about sharing all of this with you guys. We'll somehow get in touch with you. If you need help setting it up or just have questions, we'll be able to connect afterwards.
Are you going to share via Slack or emails or?
Yeah, I think if we go into the discussion area, we can discuss like emails and stuff like that.
Okay.
Yeah.
This could be really helpful, let's say, you know, if you want to break down default channel grouping, you can break down from default channel grouping to medium to source, or in Google Ads, you can add from campaign, add group or keywords. Next up. So, this is a bit similar. You also organize your dimensions, but it's the drill down option that is available down there. So if you can place a link, well, when your client enters in the view mode, it has those two arrows up there. So the data automatically switches between the drill down levels. In one chart, you can have, well, three charts or four charts, whatever. It's really useful, and your reports will have a much cleaner look. This is our integration with Google Sheets. There are some clients for which we weekly we get their average keyword score. So we track their keyword score and their competitors. This is a report that we have to do manually each week. When you connect the search Google Sheets with Data Studio and you create the chart line report, Google Data Studio automatically does this pretty chart, and it aligns you, it aligns and shows the evolution. This is where we hit a little bit of a roadblock, because Google Data Studio edits all the averages in all the weeks. Does anybody know why it did this? Why it did this?
It's dumb.
No, no, it's not dumb. It was actually something that we missed. So all of these were automated, automatically aggregated to some. Sorini, if you can just play. So you just have to switch the aggregation method to average. Google Data Studio will know to automatically create an average for both your yearly keyword average and your monthly.
Would you go for average or median?
What?
Average is the main. The median is maybe more useful for this. To make the layout as high as possible.
Yeah, that could be a good suggestion.
Thinking out loud, sorry.
Yes, yes. Thank you. So,
and one question. What kind of tool did you use for competition? I mean, you showed it.
We use a rank tracker.
Sorry?
We use a rank tracker. We have a list of keywords that we track for our website and our clients' competitors' website. And it gives us automatically that average. Okay, so you can integrate Search Console the traditional way, but we chose to do something special here. We thought that it would be okay to see the difference between the branded and non-branded queries, and to classify each of the queries into two categories. So for this, we create a calculated field, which is pretty easy, but I don't have experience in calculating MySQL or any type of programming, sorry. Okay, so you can find all sorts of adaptations that you can apply to your Google data. Even if it's in Search Console or Analytics, there are plenty of options for you to modify that data or to add new dimensions or new metrics. As you can see, we will use this newly created dimension that Google Data Studio automatically knew that it's a form of text to create new filters with it or drill down, break down dimensions. So we use this as a breakdown dimension for the chart. Next up. And well, for these other two scorecards, we have applied the filter. Next up, we'll show you how that query filter works. It's really easy when you integrate all of this data. It's like a Google Search Console dashboard. You can find a query that you deem relevant for your website, and you can see all of the landing pages that rank for the query. And it's something that you cannot see in Google Search Console. For example, you can see in Search Console all the queries and all the landing pages at the same time. You just have to filter by one of them, by your query or by landing page. Okay. This is a replay. Oh, I don't know if you had caught that earlier. Google Data Studio also have the option, also has the optional metrics feature now, which helps you, similarly to the breakdown expansion, which also helps you show more metrics in the same chart. This is a new, it's also an updated option. Conditional formatting. We have found great use in conditional formatting because it can allow you to visually see what pages are performing lower or above average. You can create reports that you can send your clients, or you can internally review reports and check where your pages are performing below average. It's really easy. You select the field, you select the condition, and you input the metric that you choose as reference. And then you have to choose some pretty colors that will catch your eyes when you're analyzing your data. Okay. So, as for the fifth part that Sorin mentioned, the one with the reporting automation. Google Data Studio allows us to schedule automatically reports each month or each week. And also we have developed the two methods that Sorin mentioned earlier, the email and the chatbot one. So let's see the automatic scheduling in Data Studio. It's pretty easy. The main thing that you have to remember is to set the general comparison default, the default date ranges to general expressions such as last month, last year, last week. You select the date that you want to send the report, and the repeat frequency. And it's pretty easy. You receive both link of the report, the client receives both the link of the report and the PDF version of it. So for the next two parts, I'm gonna ask Sorin to come back.
And one more question regarding the previous slide. You need to check the option of the sharing option, right? So in order some person who don't have a Google account or doesn't have the permission, you need to check the option in order to see the
If he has, she or he has
she needs to click on it, right?
Yes.
So there is an option you can choose if you want to share with somebody who needs the permission or anybody else who has the link, right?
Well, as long as you enter their email address, they will have access to that report.
So he or she doesn't have to have a Google
no.
account? Okay.
No.
Okay. Okay. Thanks.
So are you using like the scheduling feature in Google Data Studio?
In Adobe more than
in Adobe. Okay. So was that new to you? Like yeah, most of you yes.
Also.
Okay. Because we really didn't know about like what level people would be at in this presentation, so we were kind of nervous about like she was keep saying like no, we need to do more for these people, we need to provide more value. It's like okay, fine, we'll do it. And so we kind of what I like about Google Data Studio is that like you can push data inside, you can also like kind of combine it with other tools that you might not think of. And so these are kind of the next two kind of options are probably not documented anywhere, or at least not as of now. And it's the kind of the sort of things that I would rather spend my time on, and my team would rather spend their time on, not kind of manually doing reports. No offense to anyone who's like kind of a person that does reports on a daily basis. Hopefully, what we've shared so far will help you along the way. It's definitely things that have helped us kind of shrink down the time of doing reports from like days to like literally hours, and like clients couldn't be happier, and they also have access to like kind of more reports and they're learning more about analytics. So it's kind of a situation where everybody wins. So the first one is very simple. So it's basically, this is kind of me as a client asking the agency, oh, Sorin, where can I find this yearly report? I'm always asking this, clients are always asking this. So it's just, I'm in Gmail right now, in one of my accounts, I'm sending that over to another email account, switching over the browser to refresh it, which will take some time. How is your week been so far? There we go. So that's just basically I've received the email, right? But nothing automated about that. I go back to the first account, the client email, voila, and below the email that I've sent is, oh sure, the email, the yearly email the yearly report is here. That's just kind of a dummy link, like a celebrate GIF or whatever. I guess Gina doesn't really like it or something. If you click to the next slide, just use the space. There it is. Fine, perfect, thank you so much. So this is how we've created this. It's basically you go into like filters in Gmail, it's like in the settings toolbar, whatever, and then you create a filter and you say what do you want to search for, and you search for like the keywords yearly report, and then what do you want to do with that? Send the template. The template is something that you create. It's basically in canned responses within Gmail. If you don't have canned responses, you can activate it in the settings. And then so when email comes along and has the words yearly report somewhere in the body, it will automatically send that link. And what's very important is that link, as Alexander talked about, is kind of, once you have the link to the Google Data Studio report for like a yearly basis, it's automatically updated. You don't have to do anything. So anytime someone sends that email, any client, in any day or minute, it's the most updated version in the world. And we don't have to do that manually. So I think that's pretty amazing. Next, please. And this is kind of just to the left is how we've kind of done this. So we basically in a chatbot, we've used ChatQ, which is a free tool. We've managed to add more keywords because Gmail limits us to the number of keywords that we use. It's basically like just one or two. But these, as you see there to the left, we have like kind of variations. So anything in that range will mean that the action will become, hello, your report is here, and that's a real Google Data Studio link, and you can press the, yeah, there we go. So here I am just like a kind of a client after they've maybe logged into the system and say, oh, can I see this year's report? And bam, it's within seconds, yeah.
Is it possible to do something similar without Microsoft or not?
I think so, yeah, I think so. I think it's just about what the capability of the tools are in terms of like, kind of automation, sending things, canned response. I think canned response is kind of a usual feature in kind of anything else.
Yeah.
Great. Please. The chatbot works based on keywords, yeah?
Yeah.
So it's a year's report, but if you sent this request in Romanian, for example, would it recognize that it should be a year's report, or should it be in English?
So really quickly, so the chat tool features, it has like kind of AI, has like some translation features.
Uh-huh.
Obviously, kind of a next thing on our roadmap, if we do decide to like deploy this to all our clients, would be to kind of first scan to the like the emails or the way that people speak, and then kind of add a lot of keywords there. So sometimes we can have something like, oh, I didn't really understand your request. Are you looking for any of these options? And we could kind of save ourselves some
could
time.
Could you customize it?
Yeah, I think so.
Create your keywords for the chatbot.
Maybe not the client per se, but we like all of those we've added ourselves, and we can increase them.
Okay.
And I think it has some kind of some generic AI feature where it kind of learns things. Next slide, please. Yeah, perfect. So thank you so much for your attention. Anything we can answer, we're here and happy to help.